Good morning, student. This is Shyam Sundar Sharma. Today I am going to explain class 12 lesson RBSC solutions for class 12 English Rainbow chapter 4 Lost Spring. First question, descriptive question. Describe the living condition of Simhapuri slum. Simhapuri is situated on the periphery of Delhi. About 10,000 rag pickers live here in a structure of mud with roofs of tin and tarpaulin. They do not have sewage, drainage or running water. Children grow up in these small structures and help their parents in their survival. Rag picking is the only way for survival in Simhapuri. Garbage to them is gold. People here live in utter poverty. They are devoid of even the basic amenities of life. Health, education, sports, etc. are not even in their dreams. Their poverty does not allow them to live in hygienic and healthy life. They cannot even think of a good life and keep engaged in rag picking of some type of manual jobs. Even small children work as rag pickers in the midst of danger of a number of diseases. Hindi is before you, so you can read the Hindi translation of this paragraph. Now, question number second. Mention the circumstances which forced the bangle makers to live a life of the criminal state in Firozabad. Most of the poor people in Firozabad are engaged in bangle making. They keep working their generation after generation. They live in sheer poverty that does not allow them to think beyond the job of bangle making. They live in a very unhygienic condition. They are devoid of good health and education. They don't even have good houses to live in. They live in a very poor state. The moneylender, the middleman, the policeman, the keepers of devoid of good health and education. They don't even have good houses to live in. They live in a very good state. The money lenders, the middlemen, the policemen, the keepers of the law, the bureaucrats and the politicians have created the vicious circle from which it is very difficult for the workers in the bangle industry to get out. They accept the fate before being aware of it. The vicious circle of the poverty and injustice forces them to live a life of the primeval state. Here is the Hindi translation of the above questions. Question number third. Describe the two types of world mentioned by Annie Zhang in The Lost Spring. Annie Zhang describes the two types of world that imposes such a baggage on the children, poor families, that they cannot put down. The first is the world of the family that is caught in web of poverty. The children are burdened with the stigma of caste in which they are born. Their other world AJ, which is the circle of the saukas, the middlemen, the policemen, the keepers of the law, the bureaucrats and the politicians. These two words together weave a net of misfortune for the children of the poor families. The poverty, their poverty does not allow them even to think of a good lifestyle. The society, on the other hand, is very cruel to them in general, and people have no sympathy with these less fortunate ones and hinder their dreams of a good life. Hindi translation is below. Now you can understand by watching the Hindi translation the meaning of the above question. Question number 4. Discuss how child labor is a potential threat to life on the basis of your reading of the lesson The Lost Spring. The child labor is a blot on the forehead of humanity. We can see children working in very hazardous conditions, as we see in the lesson Lost Spring. The small children are seen as rag pickers, as laborers in Bengal picking industry. Rag picking brings them in contact with many communicable diseases. As Bengal pickers, they work in dingy hut pens in a very dim light that takes away their eyesight. Lack of proper air and sunlight poses a great threat to their life. At a very tender age, when they should have proper opportunity to grow, they have to indulge in manual jobs. It affects their health very badly. At the same time, blocks the chance of their good future. They become old before their real age. Thank you very much.